おお、すげえ。
かっこいい。
先生、武蔵先生、今のは何の流派の方ですか？
剣舞の一つだ。二刀の舞と名付けた。
でも先生、本当に二本の刀を使って戦うことなどあるのでしょうか？
いや、これはあくまで剣舞の一つだ。実際に二本の刀を同時に使うということはない。
いや、そうとも限らん。
あの人、誰？
いや、知らない。
人というものは必ず利き腕というものがある。でもごく稀に左右両方の手を同じように動かせる人間がいるのだ。
じゃあそういう人なら2本の刀を持って戦えるんですか？
ああ、そうだ。先生はそう思われますか？
どちら様ですか？
いや、いきなり道場に上がり込んで失礼いたしました。私、徳川家剣術師範補佐、丸目長吉と申します。
徳川家剣術師範。
宮本武蔵殿、あなたに折り入って話したき儀がありお邪魔いたした。できれば二人きりで話がしたいのだ。
Right, so we finally find out that Kiryu actually is Miyamoto Musashi. That's the way it's supposed to be. It's not that he's a twin or something like that. He's the same person. And here he is teaching swordsmanship in this dojo in Mimasaka province, which is where the real Miyamoto Musashi actually was from. That's in the kind of central western part of Japan. It's not very far from where the Battle of Sekigahara actually took place. And this takes place just barely before that battle, so it's several years before what we saw in the prologue as well. It's kind of a prologue to the prologue, you could say. Now what's coming up here is another tutorial. This one is about how to use the sword. Of course, it's taking on the form of Musashi teaching his students, but it's of course actually the player that is going to be the one learning. They do talk a little bit here just now about upgrading your weapons and the different kinds of swords. I'll get into that later, because right now we're not going to have any choices. We're going to actually be using Bokuto, which means a wooden sword, a training sword. They are still, in reality, you know, very dangerous, deadly actually, they can be. But in the game, anyway, they're non-lethal, although they're still a usable weapon, even outside of training. So the first step is learning how to draw your sword, which essentially means learning how to change your style. And there will be more than one style in the game, although we'll only have access to the basic one right now. So in other words, changing styles means either taking out your sword or putting it away. You can see a kind of cross shape in the upper left, and you can see a picture of our sword up there. You just push right on the directional button to draw it, and down to change to unarmed style or put your sword away. The other two styles are blocked out right now. We won't get those in this video. The students all have kind of joke names, you could say. They have the numbers of their position in their name, except the first one, he didn't. He just had the word sword in his name. But the others are actually number 2, 3, 4, and 5, and this is number 3. What I mean by that is that their names have 3 kanji, and the middle one is the kanji for the number of their position. Alright, so now we're going to actually attack. We're going to learn how to chain our attacks, which is exactly the same thing as chaining them with our fists. You can do a few weak attacks with square, or more powerful ones with triangle. So we'll see what that looks like. Yeah, there's the word Bokuto. You'll see that a lot, and actually some of the swords you can use wind up actually being bokuto. That means that, of course, they're non-lethal, but they're not necessarily weaker. So we just chain three attacks with square. As long as you're only using square, that's the most you can do. If you just use triangle, you can only do one attack. But you can mix them. Alright, so now we're going to do a chain attack and then follow it up with the triangle move, which will do extra damage and has a better chance to stun an enemy. Although, this is training, so our student is of course going to block everything. He won't get stunned. So you can do it after one, two, or three weak attacks with square. You can press triangle, hold it, and do a follow-up attack. It's good to mix it up, keep the enemy off guard. That actually is a viable technique. Of course, when you use the follow-up attack like that, you tend to have a little more recovery time, and you may have your back open to the enemy. Alright. He's going to show us what he learned. That means it's time for us to block. It's absolutely the same. No difference between the unarmed block and armed block, except that if you're unarmed and he's armed, he's just going to cut right through it. A bokuto can block a regular sword, though. That's not an issue. With the single sword style, we can block on three sides. Just not behind us, but you can block left and right. Which is immensely useful. If you had to be just really centered on him, it would basically be a useless move. Although, as I think I said in the prologue, it's really better to dodge most of the time anyway. I should mention that Marume Nagayoshi is actually, he was a real guy too. Although, actually, he's not as famous as his presence in this game might make you think. I'll get into the background of some of these people a little more later on, when I have more opportunity to talk, and we're not doing tutorials. Yeah, Bullshiro. She, number four. Okay, now we're going to learn the guard break. It's not the most useful technique, and I'll get into that once we see it in action. In fact, you may pretty much never see me use it during the regular playthrough, except just to show you what it looks like. Press circle to guard break. So if you're in the unarmed style, circle grabs him by the collar or throws him. But with anything else, any weapon in our hand, it kicks. And yeah, it breaks his guard, but the problem is that basically any enemy, even on the lower difficulty, recovers faster from your kick than you recover from doing the kick. So you can't really exploit the breach. I don't know, maybe it works on easy. I never played on that, so who knows. It can be used occasionally, maybe to interrupt an enemy's attack, but just like a lot of attacks, the really powerful enemies where that would be an issue are immune to it. So, again, not the most useful technique, but I will mix it in once in a while just for variety's sake. I said that we're using Bokuto now, but the main swords are called Tachi, as opposed to Katana. It's actually a matter of debate even if there's a difference or what the difference is, but that's how the game refers to them. And the single sword style is known as the Itto style, and it just means one sword. We'll also have Kodachi, which is like the short sword or dagger. Samurai used to carry both, and then we can use that by itself as well. That's not considered a separate like style or technique. The game doesn't even explain it, but once we get into real fights, we'll be able to just whip that out anytime we want. It has a few of its own like special moves and heat actions. Alright, we're going to get a demonstration, or we're going to give a demonstration of Zanchin, and that is a technique exclusive to Kenzan in the Yakuza series, and the reason is it is a heat gauge building action that you use with swords. If you are using a weapon, if you're not in the unarmed style, you cannot grab and you cannot taunt, so there has to be another way to gain heat, and this is what we're doing. When you do your follow-up strong attack with triangle, you keep and hold the triangle button, and your sword glows like that, and you get a good amount of heat out of it while it's glowing. The longer you hold it, the longer it works, up to a couple of seconds. But you're wide open, and you can't move while you're doing it. So, you know, it's not always a viable thing to do. You gotta be well away from the enemy. It is really the main technique we're going to use to build up heat, though, because we're almost always going to be using a weapon. Zangoro Go is 5. Musashi is his given name, and you know, most people in Japan would be known by their last name, in this case Miyamoto. Marume's last name is Marume, but Musashi is just so famous, and very few real people are named Musashi, and no one was at that time except him, really, that he's just known by his first name.
ようやく門下生の方にお帰りいただけましたな。
丸目殿でしたね。折り手ようとは道場破りでもなさるおつもりかな。いやいや、そのようなことをするつもりはない。実は宮本殿にある試験を受けていただけないかと。試験？何の試験ですか？ある仕事の。仕事？そう、 近い将来必ず起こる東と西の天下分け目の戦いで仕事をお引き受けいただけないかと。徳川ということは東軍への士官の誘いか。そのための試験だと。いや、そうではない。ではどういった仕事なのでしょうか。それは試験に合格してからでないと話せない。何せ この国を揺るがしかねない大仕事ゆえ、宮本殿、ここは一つ何も聞かずに試験を受けてもらえないだろうか。いきなりやってきて試験を受けるとは失礼にも程がある。この話乗れないな。徳川家師範代への道が開けているとしてもか。何？ 仕事が成功した暁には、私があなたを徳川家師範代に推挙する。約束する。あの徳川の。いよいよやってくる東と西の戦いで徳川は天下を統一する。そうすればゆくゆくは天下の師範代ということに。あなたも剣士として このような道場で一生を終えるつもりではありますまい。ここは一つ私の話に乗って試験をしてみないか、宮本殿。
どんな試験なんだ？
試験は至って簡単。今ここで 私と一試合してもらう。
あなたと。
ああ。何、心配はない。どのような結果であろうと、お命を奪うようなことはいたしません。いかがするか。
All right, so he wants to give us a test, which involves a duel with Bokuto. So, as I said, they can be very painful and potentially kill someone, but in the game they're non-lethal, so this is not a duel to the finish. And technically, he gives us a choice, but, you know, this is a story choice, so in other words, it's not a choice. Either way, you're going to wind up taking the test. All right, here we go. Our first, I guess you could call it a boss. Marume is tough. In fact, you're not supposed to win this fight. You barely do any damage to him on extreme, and we take a lot of damage. The fight will end if our health gets too low, if our health is at level 1 or 2, whatever it is now, like this, then it'll end when you get about 3/4 of the way down. It's kind of a strange fight because they just finished teaching you all these techniques and now none of them work on him. The only way to hit him is like that. You wait for his strike and you hope it's not one that's a triple chain, and then you jab him with the triangle button. That's the only time his guard is down. You can't get behind him. You cannot chain him. You cannot break his block. You can with the kick, but he recovers faster and just beats you down for it. And his normal attacks all break your guard, so then he just follows up with another one, which knocks you to the ground. He stays on his feet, you don't, and he can stun lock you. He'll just keep you in the corner and just keep hitting you on the head as you try to get up. It is possible to beat him, though, and I will upload a bonus video of me doing that in a little bit. Yeah, you can't do that to him yet. So we have only the most basic of movesets in the game. And the thing about this fight is that even on a New Game Plus, you'll have a longer health bar, but that's going to be the only difference. Because in Kenzan, unlike all the other Yakuza games, when you level up, you do not get points to spend on raising abilities. All you get is a longer health gauge and a longer heat gauge. You have to learn abilities from teachers, and they don't carry over into a new game.
かな、宮本殿。実力はよくわかった。合格だ。え？合格だ、宮本殿。明日の朝、共に出立しよう。旅支度をするがよい。
Alright, that's a good question. Like I said, he is a fight you're supposed to lose, so even if you beat him, that cutscene doesn't change. but I'll show it off anyway later on. So, I guess I should talk just a little bit about the Battle of Sekigahara, since that's really everything is based around that. It was East versus West. It was Tokugawa from Edo / Tokyo against the forces of Osaka, who were loyal to the previous rulers or power brokers. And they were organized by Ishida Mitsunari, who was just, he was one of many lords who participated. Prior to that, pretty much all of the great samurai families and rulers had been under or as part of the Toyotomi clan. That was Tomotori Hideyoshi, who had taken over after Oda Nobunaga and pretty much ruled the country, even though he wasn't technically shogun. But 2 years before this, he died. And that was when Tokugawa, who was now the most senior member, he saw his opportunity, since Hideyoshi's son was just a child, and he decided to try and seize control. So there was a series of struggles, and people who were more loyal to the western side and to the boy, Hideyoshi's son, opposed him. They became the Western Army, and Tokugawa's army became the Eastern Army. And, of course, everyone would know that Tokugawa won, and that's what started the Edo period and 250 years of more or less peace. The real Miyamoto Musashi is thought to have fought at Sekigahara, but he would have been just a teenager, and he almost certainly fought on the western side against Tokugawa. But, we see that Marume is trying to recruit him. So I should tell you that this bears almost no resemblance to the real life of Miyamoto Musashi. In fact, the game is more based on some samurai films that were made about his life, and especially the book Musashi by Yoshikawa Eiji. But even that, you can go ahead and read it, and you're not going to spoil yourself at all for the game. It's extremely loose. Loose doesn't even begin to describe how loose the interpretation of the book is. The story and plot and characterization is completely different. In fact, the only thing that's really the same is just some of the characters actually show up and have the same names, but their personalities aren't even the same most of the time. So this is an original story, actually. Taking liberties with the story of Miyamoto Musashi is a time-honored tradition in Japan. In fact, not a lot is actually known about his real life. So I guess we can make up whatever we want. For instance, Marume did not appear at all in the book. So, and in the book, Musashi at 16 did fight on the western side at Sekigahara, and that's actually the opening. But that's, of course, not what is happening here. Here we see Musashi as probably meant to be in his 20s. Like many, he'd trained a lot in the dojo and learned a lot of techniques in school, but he'd never been in real battle, because at this time there weren't really a lot going on in this area. And he doesn't have a house that he belongs to, a lord's house. So there wouldn't have been a lot of reason for him to be in battles. But now is kind of his opportunity to try himself out, and Marume is asking him to join the eastern side. Although he did say he doesn't exactly want him to join the army, he has another job for him, and we'll find out what that is in just a little bit. Or that's one of the save points, the Jizo statues we learned about last time. They sparkle, they shine, that's all I can say about them. Right now we cannot access an item box, can't do that for a little while, but we can still save. And here's an odd little mechanic of Kenzan. You can find these turtles lying around, and they're usually in places like this that you can never go back to. They don't have any effect on the story, they don't help you get any abilities. What there is later on is a little mini-game involving them. And I have not experimented with this, I'm not sure if it makes much difference, but supposedly if you help these turtles, you get an advantage in them later. The minigame is turtle racing, and so your turtles will be better if you rescue the turtles you find around. I've always done it, so I don't know if it makes a difference not to, but the turtle minigame is pretty damn hard anyway, so I'm not going to be showing you like high scores or anything, I'm just going to be showing it off and probably losing. want to mention that Marume calls Kiryu, or Miyamoto, Musashi, Miyamoto Dono. You don't hear that too much in the game. You pretty much never hear that now, except maybe in some really seriously hierarchical organizations. Dono is a very respectful term for someone who is your inferior. So, of course, Marume is one of the highest-ranking samurai in, well, maybe in the country, but at least in the Tokugawa army, and Musashi's just a ronin, so he calls him Marume-san, but Marume calls him Miyamoto Dono. In this game, it's pretty much just Marume who uses that term with other people.
宮本殿、どうして私があなたに声をかけたのか、わかるか。いいや。それはな、お主には型というものがないからだ。型？ああ、そうだ。剣士として道場を持つほどの人間なら、誰しもがそれなりの流派というものを持っている。だが、 宮本殿の剣には型というものが存在しない。つまり俺には剣士としての基礎がないと。いや違う。いくら高名で強いとされる流派を継いでいても弱き者は弱い。剣の強さというのは悲しいかな、人を斬って初めて身につくものだ。人を斬って。そうだ。 私が探していたのは、すでに何人もの人を殺してきた手だれの剣士と、まだ血を浴びていない無垢の剣士。どうしてそのような組み合わせを？戦場で生き残るには、二つの能力が必要だからだ。二
つの能力。一
つは戦いの経験。そしてもう一つは、戦いへの好奇心。
好奇心？
そう、好奇心。つまり人を斬るということへの強き欲求。
じゃあ俺は、その好奇心を持った剣士だと。
まあ、そういうことになる。
随分勝手な理由だな。別に俺は、人を斬ることが好きで剣士をやっているわけじゃない。
そんなことはない。
え？
最後の最後まで勝つことを諦めず、この私に剣を向けた。その時の眼差し、あれは本気で人を殺す人間の眼差しだった。宮本殿。
なんだ。戦場で
経験は時に役立ち、時に足かせになる。
手だれの剣士ほど自分の腕の限界を知っている。そういった剣士は戦場で自分より強い敵に出会ってしまった場合、その場から逃げ出すか、もしくは戦わずして死ぬ。逃げるか。俺には考えられんな。そう、それだ。
お主のような経験がなく、それでいて強き心の持ち主は強大な敵にも立ち向かえる。今回の作戦ではその心が一番必要なのだ。
なんか今から死ねと言われてるような気分だな。
それほど困難な作戦であるということだ。
どんな作戦なんだ。俺には想像もつかない。
時が来たら告げる。今話すことができないのだ。どうする？引くなら今しかないぞ、宮本殿。
いや、こんな片田舎の道場でくすぶるくらいなら、俺はたとえ危険でも腕を試す方を選ぶ。夜遅くにすまなかった。
宮本武蔵か。死なせるには少々惜しい男だ。だが仕方ない。これも剣士の定め。